One Shaper 1000 here, and there's Monkey. We're on the boat, doing a little adjusting on the motor. Seems sluggish today for some reason, but it is getting wide open throttle. So, might have to get a different pitch prop. But I got this thing hooked up here. I don't know how well this is going to work, but I got it tied. So that way, if it comes off, it shouldn't fall off into the water. It shouldn't. I don't know.
What?
I got it on backwards. Oh, crap. Damn it.
Hi, guys.
Okay, so I thought that through, but apparently I didn't.
I'm sorry, babe. You try so hard.
I know it.
Really do.
Nope, that's not gonna work. Well, okay, so, all right, guys. Oops, getting in some seaweed here. I guess I gotta flip this around. This right,
mm-hmm.
And put this in. Bear with me, guys. I think I got my mic problem figured out. Okay, now I'm gonna put that up there. We're gonna put the magnet on. Going on with the magnet. Oh.
There you go. You got it.
Gosh, man. Whoops. All right. Let's do a little ride, I guess. Monkey, will you hand me a pop while we're sitting still?
Yep.
Hope you guys can hear me. I hope I got this mic figured out. If I did, then I'll tell you what I think the issue was. Sorry. But, and the depth finder's not working for some reason. Take it back to Walmart and get another one. Well, that's where you bought it at.
Yep.
Just exchange it. Our horn quit working.
It was working just a second ago.
Yeah.
This thing is haunted.
It's a haunted boat, guys. This thing is,
it's haunted.
Now the horn's not working. That's weird. What the hell, man? Alright. Well, let's go for a ride, I guess. That's a little better. Still taking forever to get up on plane, though. Yeah, that's weird. Man, that makes me mad. It's upsetting. Spend all that time trying to do something nice, then get out on the water and nothing wants to work. The Garmin don't want to work, the horns don't want to work. Damn thing's running sluggish. Idle zone. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the horn. I just beeped it back there.
Yeah, one time it beeped. That was it. Gotta be something loose connection.
Hon, I put them connections on myself.
I know.
So they're not loose. And they're heat shrinking. They're heat shrinking. They're heat shrinking. They're heat shrinking, guys. They're heat shrinked. That really blows. Could be the button, I guess.
Maybe.
Ooh, see, we're in shallow water here. The radio is working. It's all on the same power unit up here. Lights are working. I think the mic's still working. Looks like it. It's the only camera I brought. Well, I got my phone, so I always have a camera. Nice house.
Yep.
So, it's a surprise. We get to move in next week.
Oh, gee, thank you.
What, that ain't good enough for you?
Yes. Well, go with it, too.
See? I can't even give you a $1.5 million house and you want something more.
Well, I just wondered, that's all.
No, they gave me the option, the fire pit or the boat. I took the fire pit. Because we're in Florida, everybody's got a boat.
That's right.
So, you know, I chose the fire pit.
It is beautiful. It's got a nice spot. People just got it
fucking made. Yep.
And their whole life has been nothing but good. You know? No sadness. No.
There's sadness in everybody's life. Just some people choose not to let it bother them. You know, I mean, look at all the people that I've known since I've been down here that's passed away. 50, 60 of them, you know, family members and stuff. My sister passed away. But yeah, I was sad, don't get me wrong, but you know, she wouldn't want me to sit and linger on it.
No, she would not. Uh-huh.
She She'd be like, you better get out there and enjoy yourself, buddy. And yeah. I know my sister. Don't cry for me. That's what she would tell me.
Yeah.
Remember the good times. That's why I told you, when something happens to me, if I go before you, huh?
Look at the duckies.
Yeah. If I go before you, you know, have a party, you know, play my videos, laugh and joke, you know? You know what I mean? And to the people that can't come and see me when I'm alive, don't come and see me when I'm dead.
Yeah.
You know? Well, I understand people in Ohio can't just pop up and visit, you know?
No, but they text you. Sometimes.
Yeah, but I'm saying, you know, think about it. If you can't go see someone when they're alive, don't go see them when they're dead and sit and talk about how you miss them when you haven't seen them in the last 5 years. You know? I can't tell how deep you are because that thing ain't working.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I see a pontoon there. There's a pontoon boat there.
Yeah.
Can't be that low. I mean, I'm sure it's shallow, but not, you know.
There you go, it's for sale.
Yep.
Right there, that's what we need. That's our house. Holy shit. All I need is money.
We need a little bit more money than what we can get out of ours.
I don't know.
Even though our house, I mean, think about what that's going to go for, because our house is pushing $200,000.
Yeah.
In town. So you're right on the lake.
Yeah.
I mean, it don't have a dock, but I would just go buy an old junk pontoon and build a dock.
It has the steps for it. Perfect.
Yeah, but that's what I would do.
Yeah.
Is I would just buy an old pontoon boat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we saw that too. Didn't you take a video picture of that?
I don't know.
I think you did. Showed it last time you were out here, I think. That's a pretty house. That's the house. I got it. That's my dream house right there. I mean, I love my house. I really do.
Yeah. But if we ever... if we ever sold it... But if we ever got wealthy, I would just buy a house on the lake.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Airbnb our house, and our house would pay for the new house.
Yeah.
Because our house is paid for.
Yeah.
You know, we owe nothing on it.
Yeah. It's a little different than where we were the last time. Oh, yeah, look at these houses. They've got it made.
Well, you don't know that, though. Not every one of them's got it made. There's probably somebody in this house right now crying how they're going to pay the mortgage this month.
Probably.
They're late. You see what I mean? I mean,
I know.
You think we haven't lived a good life, but how many people can just go buy a house and pay in $100 bills? You did that. You own your house. It's paid for. The car's paid for. The boat's paid for. You owe a penny on nothing.
You should have seen their mouths when I did that. For I paid the house.
See, if I was going to pay $30,000 for something, I would really mess with them.
There's a birdie.
Yeah, it's a bird. I would mess with them and I would get all $20 bills. Especially if I was a female and tell them I've been saving dancing all these years. And I'd bring it in a big jug. This is my tip money from when I was dancing. You know, mess with them a little bit. Wow, where'd you get all this cash? I can't tell you that. If you really want to know, I cannot tell you that.
All right, you get the idea. That's funny.
Just like when we went to bank, get the money to buy the truck. What are you going to do with that money? None of your damn business.
Yeah, I couldn't believe that.
Well, we don't recommend you carrying around $9,000. I don't recommend you telling us what to do with our money. Remember, I was pissed.
Oh, yeah, I know. And we had to go all the way where the car was, and we had to go to use their bank. And they're like, oh, no problem.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Because when we went in there, she told them what we had went through, and they was like, well, it's none of their damn business. I said, exactly. Yeah. I was mad.
Yeah.
Well, I need to call my manager, and I don't know if I can get a hold of. Look, this is our money.
Yeah.
You can't constitute what, this is America. I was pissed. Well, let's just go to the other bank. Now, wait a minute. No, we're going to another bank. And we did. When we got in Spring Hill, we went to the bank there, and they said, no problem. It's your money. Well, you know, we got to wait on this to clear. We'll give you a check. No, I don't want a check. I'm at the bank. I want cash money.
Yeah.
Yeah, banks can't tell you what you can do with your money. And did you know that law now, like if you got, say, $500,000 in the bank and you want to withdraw it, they got 72 hours to get you your money. Because that's your money. You know, they can't hold it, and they can't say, you know, tell you what to do with it or advise against it. If you have all the necessary documents, you know, it's your money. They have to give it to you, and they got to give it what you want, you know.
Yeah.
That's why they don't like you pulling out of the bank, because, you know, that's money that they're lending people. That's how that works, you know. Mm-hmm. They lend people your money, charge them extra money to pay back, and you get not a dime out of it.
Yep.
So they're using your money to make money.
Yeah, that's what they're doing.
You don't get no kickback from that.
Uh-uh.
So, you know, I just can't stand when somebody has not one damn payment and complaining about, man, we've had a rough life. Really? I mean, you know, you bought your Toyota, $6,000, went and paid him cash.
Yeah.
Bought the house, $30,000, paid in cash.
Yeah.
We bought our truck, $8,000, paid in cash.
Yeah.
Both boats we bought, sat there and counted out the money.
Yeah.
You know?
That's the way to do it. Don't owe anything.
But some people can't. I understand that. So we can't sit and complain, wow, they got it made. Not necessarily, because I'll bet you 90% of these homes ain't paid for.
Oh, probably not, no.
You know, that one that's for sale, that's over $1 million. And I guarantee ain't somebody just sat and wrote $1 million check.
Right.
I guarantee you they didn't. They mortgaged that shit.
Oh, yeah. Sure do.
But that's how we would do that. We would Airbnb our house and let it pay for the new house. That way, if something happened, we still own a house. You see what I'm saying? Don't mortgage it if you don't have to, and we wouldn't have to.
Right. That's the way to do it if you can do it. Oh, he got a boo-boo on his shed there.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's about what your roof looked like.
Yeah.
Once I showed you in the drone, they got the tarp off, he was like, oh my God, that looks like an abandoned house.
It does.
Exactly. That's what happens to them. You get one hole in it, and it ain't long. So if that wasn't covered up, your house would look like any other abandoned house you've ever been in. That's how quick it goes. I mean, you know, because it can't dry up inside the walls.
Yeah. I'm just happy we got a new roof.
It's a bird, huh?
Yeah, I like birdies. I always like birdies. I told you, when I go, I want to be a bird. I come back. That's me. I want to be a bird. So I can fly around the world.
Birds don't fly around the world.
No, they need to.
Even ones that migrate, they just kind of go so far, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah. Maybe I can get to Europe somehow.
They can't fly across the ocean, hon. There's nowhere to land and take a break. There's no food. Yeah, that roofing on that place right there.
Yeah.
That's what I wanted to do with the hut. That changed. Yeah. That changed very quickly and dramatically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that stuff ain't cheap.
Yeah, it cost us like almost $700
to put
a roof like that on our little hut.
Yeah.
Around $700. I'm like, for a hut? Nah.
That ain't worth it.
Nah, we're not doing that.
My dad did that at the motel. We had two picnic tables on the deck, and it was really hot, you know, so he made a hut, and that's what he used. He used that stuff.
Yeah, but yeah. Remember, back then...
He built the rest of it.
But back then, that stuff wasn't expensive.
No, it wasn't.
And, you know, we're talking a motel for people to go enjoy every day. Not just a hut in the backyard that we're going to use once a month maybe for camping out in. No. I can't see putting that kind of money into it.
It was nice too. People used to pick the tables more because they had shelter.
What's that say?
I don't know. It was orange.
What's it say? I know it's orange.
Device overheated. Screen will be something.
Alright. Well, I'm going to take you guys off. I'll shut you down. Let this cool off. And then I'll bring you back here in a few. It's all right. I think it's a little underpowered. Need to shoot this one up and get a 40 horse. Johnson or Evinrude.
What's better, you think? Evinrude?
They're both the same because later in years they called them Johnson Evinrude.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Same people are them?
I'm not sure about that, but.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. But Johnson parts will fit in Evinrude, and Evinrude will fit in Johnson parts. They're like coils and stuff like that.
I don't know.
The top.
I don't know. I'm not very good judgment.
Going on there, Monk?
I don't know. I think it's a t-shirt contest going on. That was fun. It cooled me off.
Didn't cool me off. It felt warm. Well, this stayed on.
Back here.
That bridge on the Walker Grill, where I fished that one time, it's up here.
Oh, really?
That's the road to go to the house. Wow. The back way? Mm-hmm. Yeah, past the nursing homes right up here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
You know, I can see that water off to the right.
Yeah.
Where they just did a lot of work on that house up here. They just built a house. This is it.
Oh, this shit.
Water, yeah.
Wow.
sure it's not gonna be the last time that we're bumping the prop.
Nope.
Shallow, you can see where the water is usually up there.
Yeah.
We never brought the other boat back here because of the seaweed.
Yeah.
Because reverse didn't work great.
Yeah.
Remember, and I couldn't spin it off the prop. And I was constantly pulling the motor out. You know.
Yeah.
So like this one, you know, you can hit reverse.
Uh-huh.
And 90% of the time, to, you know, because it spins the prop the other way. And it'll 90% of the time, not 100%, but it'll clean the prop out a little bit for you. We'll know in a minute. Actually, when you come through low places like that, and it's just seaweed, you should have your engine at a higher RPM anyway. It wrapped up and helps chop it up, you know? That's a walking trail right there.
Yep, it is.
Walking trail right ahead.
Sure.
Seen a basket boat go under there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep, that's the walking trail. Seen a bass boat going through there.
Nice.
Can't even more than scuff something up.
Right.
Whoa, whatever that was big.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me know before we get committed.
I'm gonna close my eyes. I don't know. It's really hard to judge. Oh, wow. Very scary.
Wow.
We did it.
Ain't got much room on either side of that one, do we?
No.
Woo.
What a scary.
We only got to do it one more time.
Yeah, we'll
come
back.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's where I fished that one. Didn't at first.
No, I didn't. No, I know.
Down there, I believe, is the road. We go on like our turning road that way.
Yeah.
You know, when we come out and we usually turn right, if we go left, that's where you come down. See this trailer park? That's that trailer park.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I know where that trailer park is.
Boat go through there.
Yeah.
What's that say? Danger?
I don't know.
I don't like the looks of that.
Danger.
Underwater underwater obstruction.
What's that mean?
That means there's stuff underneath there that you can hit. No, we got close to it and you chickened out. I said, no, let's not do that. I don't think this cord works in here. See the seaweed?
Yeah, I see the seaweed. Lots.
You don't have your cord on you, do you?
No.
Crap. I only got 15% battery on this cord. Or on this camera, so I'm gonna stop it for now. All right, well, let's go under this first, and then I'll stop it.
Yeah.
Watch, we'll get tangled in the seaweed, and the motor won't work, and I won't be able to steer.
That would be hard.
Foreshadowing.
Yeah.
charging.
No.
But that other cord we had for the fan, it was charging the fan.
Oh, mine shot down. Why did mine turn on?
I don't know.
I don't either. I still have battery. Oh, my SD card's full.
Oh, well, that'll cause it.
Wow. Yeah, I guess I'm done.
Yeah, look at the bolts. If we hit one of them bolts wrong.
Yeah. Like that?
I didn't hit it. What do you mean like that? I didn't hit nothing. Just making sure we didn't. Alright, now I'm gonna cut it off and I'll finish the video. We get back to we're gonna head back, alright?
Yeah.
Alright. Thank you. up there just. Holy shit. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed that. Monkey's gone up to get the truck. She got to take it down around there. I think I'll just wait here this time. But yeah, other than the depth finder not working and horns not working, I don't know, because everything else is all the lights, the stereo, of course the motor's running. So I don't know. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Shea Bear, the myth, the man, the legend. I'm gone for now. We just had to get out for a few hours, you know what I mean? So, but yeah, we're talking about maybe getting a 40 horse and putting on here. I don't know how, it looks dark in that. There you go. Talking about maybe getting a 40 horse and putting on this thing. So yeah, that'd really make it come alive. So, all right, guys, thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Take care. Be safe, everyone.